Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome, man. Welcome to Beyond Classic Rock. Today, man, I've got an album reaction for you, and this is featuring the music of Jack White. Jack White is formerly of the White Stripes with his wife, Meg White. And so this is his solo works, man, an album called Boarding House Reach. So I just want to give a shout out first and a thanks to Cole. Thank you very much for the recommendation, man. I did Elephant previously, the White Stripes album, and Cole had recommended that as well. Cole says, hey STB, I got some more Jack White that I think you'll enjoy. This is my personal favorite of his solo albums. It's one of the strangest rock albums I've heard, but I still absolutely love it. It's very different from his stuff with the White Stripes. It's called Boarding House Reach. Hope you enjoy. Right on, man. I think I'll probably enjoy anything Jack White has done. So far, he's just knocking 100. So, let's hit this up, man. Full album. Let's go all the way through. Boarding House Reach. I wonder what that means. I'm sure we'll figure it out. Let's get it.
Woman, don't you know what I'm suffering from? Ease my pain, make it wash out with the rain. Relieve me and put it up on your tail. Take it away and give it to somebody else. 'Cause I know we're connected by love. Yes, I know. What have I done? I have
pushed away everyone. Help me forget. Let's put it all to bed. Forgive me and save me from myself. Don't forsake me, woman, and go and choose somebody else. 'Cause I know.
We'll be right back. question. Who's listening? Nowadays, that's how you get adulation. Who wants to start a corporation?
He's making some sort of a political statement in this song. Good tune. Abulia. And
he's a mighty man.
I renounce wholeheartedly in this extreme abjuration, that which I repudiate so vehemently, adamantly, unrepentant, implacable and intractable, I abdicate with inexorable pleasantry. In this solemn refutation, this most earnest repudiation, I shall not negate that which I state irrevocably. But I do it so gently that you cannot resent me for this humble request of my company. So with time left permitting, and while we are still sitting, may I please have another cup of tea?
I was just starting to get into that shit. Hyper misophonic.
Sounds like a dynamite blast.
some nice funky jams in this album so far. Some weird shit too. Interesting.
Seem to remember the dates. I lay low and turn off the lamps. Come on over, you can lick the stamps. And we can put together a folio and sing hallelujah in stereo. Keep the father, baby, let him into the fold. But keep the car running on molten gold. We got fever, there ain't no cure, girl. Take out insurance if you ain't too sure, girl. We do the things that lovers do well. Never have to ever hear the rings of school bells. Plaid jeans, no cellular phone. Cause I got feelings that you just don't know. And you can listen up if you want to hear. And if you can't stand it, then right here. The name of the tune is Cool Hand Luke, cause I got stripes on my pants and boots. In prison you can learn a lesson from the analog to the hotbox session. Listen.
Sponsored by Hello. Hello. Welcome to Everything You've Ever Learned. Brought to you by
Do you want everything?
Wow. It's making a strong statement about, I guess, our way of life and our lack of understanding, lack of commitment towards knowledge, something like that. Holding my breath for the lyrics to drop because he seems to always have something very serious to talk about. Why am I visualizing this lady in 5-inch spikes on and leather and wigs and shit?
Shoes and grabs her tenor pacifier from its stand. 30 half steps to the microphone, smile on her face, flower in her hand. Oh, how a crowd can melt when they've been dealt such a deliciously delicate blow. By a barefooted fairy, not with a clang but a whisper, totally stealing the show. Fools desire distraction and not take to heart their faces to their gadgets fall south, ignoring the beauty of fog on a hill and a kitten with a mouse in its mouth. A motley mob settles down, and there's hardly a frown as the air in the temple turns to mist. Spotlight, a mark, and a cleanse of the throat, and her microphone gently is kissed. You can hear a bootlace and a speck of dust taste as the babe bravely stared down the herd. But she played not a note, and only one moment spoke these simple and poignant five words: "You people are totally absurd."
Seems like a crowd that doesn't appreciate creativity.
When I was young, I went into an abandoned house. And in one of the rooms, I found an old piano. I didn't know how to play piano, so I just fumbled across the keys. Press the pedals down. I sat there for hours trying to understand how to construct a melody. My brain to my fingertips. And after a while, I hit three notes together at the same time.
Invisible to you.
Wow, that was trippy as shit.
Strains of humoresque divine, you thrill and fill this heart of mine with gladness like a soothing symphony. O'er the air you'll gently flow into my soul, you'll strike a note of passion.
Doesn't this sound like something Paul McCartney would say? Humoresque. Was a damn good album. Different in a good way. A little cerebral. Got some funky ass grooves. Got some really, really awesome riffs. Good singing, harmonizing, rapping. Everything was in this album, man. Never a dull moment. And a really nice kind of a sublime touch to it at the very, very end there with Humoresque. And I don't know, it just took me to Paul McCartney's way of singing, you know? So yeah, this guy, man, Jack White. Overall, what am I trying to say? This is a talented, talented dude, let me tell you. He's got some serious skills, got some great talent. And I have no doubt that everything he's done is pretty right on. You know, I'm sure that he hasn't done anything bad. I'll go out on a limb and say that without knowing all of his stuff. But the limited exposure to Jack White that I've had over the years, I've been impressed as hell with this guy, man. Very, very talented. Very talented. Smart, keen, sharp. How old is he? He's what? Probably not even 40 yet. I don't think he is. Still got such a long way to go and so much more to offer us, man. It's really, really cool. I'd love to get more acquainted with the rest of his stuff as well. All right, so you know what I'll do here? We'll check out the album information, but first let's take a look at Jack himself, because I've only introduced him as Meg and Jack White. So let's just look at the man himself, Jack White. Jack White, John Anthony White, is an American singer, songwriter, multi-instrumentalist, and producer. He is best known as lead singer and guitarist of the duo The White Stripes. White has enjoyed consistent critical and popular success and is widely credited as one of the key artists in the garage rock revival of the 2000s. He has won 12 Grammy Awards, and three of his solo albums have reached number one on the Billboard charts. Rolling Stone ranked him number 70 on its 2010 list of the 100 greatest guitarists of all time. Wow. And this was back then. He was very young and still hadn't really done a lot of, well, he's probably done a hell of a lot of work, but you know, still so much more to go. Already making that damn list. White is a board member of the Library of Congress National Recording Preservation Foundation. His record label and studio, Third Man Records, releases vinyl recordings of his own work as well as that of other artists and local schoolchildren. Lazaretto holds the record for most first week vinyl sales since 91. White has an extensive collection of guitars and other instruments and has a preference for vintage items that often have connections to famous blues artists. He is a vocal advocate for analog technology and recording techniques. Smart man. That's where all of the magic was. That's where a part of that whole creative bug, creative renaissance and all of that sort of thing, the magic of the music comes from, you know? He knows where it's at. Boarding House Reach. Boarding House Reach is the third studio album by American rock musician Jack White, released March 23, 2018 through Third Man Records, Columbia Records, and XL Recordings. The album was written in Nashville and recorded throughout 2017 at Third Man Studio in Nashville, Sear Sound in New York City, and Capitol Studios in LA. Connected by Love and Respect Commander were released together as a double single on January 10th. Corporation, Over and Over and Over, and Ice Station Zebra were released as singles afterwards. Boarding House Reach received generally positive reviews, with an unorthodox production and style noted as a departure from White's previous studio albums and projects. While critics mainly praised the album for its ambition, experimentalism, and artistic approach, its criticisms mainly focused on its inconsistency and production. The album performed well commercially, topping the US Billboard 200 upon release, making it White's third number one album on that chart. Elsewhere, it was a number one album in Canada and reached number five in Scotland, Switzerland, and the UK. Oh yeah, holy cow. There is a lengthy ass review here, from AllMusic. Stephen Thomas Erlewine of AllMusic. These guys are good with their reviews, man, so it's worth reading. Let's read it. Due to his affection for pre-war music and myths, Jack White often gets pigeonholed as a blues rock revivalist, an assessment that isn't so much wrong as it's incomplete. Even in the earliest days of the White Stripes, White limited his oral palate with deliberate zeal, a practice he sustained through the Stripes as well as his first two solo albums. Boarding House Reach is where he expands his horizons, and that discipline begins to fracture, and quite intentionally so. Connected by Love, the album's opening track and first single, is a rousing bit of arena rock and the only cut that could truly have appeared on either Blunderbuss or Lazaretto. I guess his two previous albums. Once that song draws to a close, White dives into a moody electronic meditation called Why Walk a Dog. Okay, so that's why it's so long. He's going through each particular song and touching each particular song as he goes in. That's why it's such a lengthy review. So, okay, let's skip over all of that part and just get down to his final thoughts. Every moment suggests that White is kicking against the pricks, desperate to be seen as a modern rock artist, not a fusty throwback. While his attempt at redefinition is a success, there is no question that this is the work of an artist willing to take risks. It's an open question whether Boarding House Reach succeeds as an album. Its diffused nature is enthralling, but it also means that the record has a halting momentum, a perhaps inevitable byproduct of a musician eager to drive himself into the ditch. Another odd element of Boarding House Reach is how, despite his thirst to get weird, White is by nature a very regimented artist who has a desire to have everything in its right place. Yeah, I get that feel too. Corporation and Ice Station Zebra, the two funkiest numbers here, illustrate this with their precise grooves, but even the self-consciously weird interludes show this same level of exactitude. I've never heard that word before. While that keeps Boarding House Reach somewhat in a straitjacket, it also makes it a fascinating listen because it's a document of a control freak anxious to get loose. AllMusic, they're always giving really, really interesting reviews, aren't they? Don't they? Even if they are not really big or keen on what they're reviewing, they'll always find a really good way of describing it, you know? I gotta give these guys a shout out one day. All right, y'all. So that is our look at this really interesting, different, but really cool album, Boarding House Reach. What do you think of it? Let me know what you think of it. I think it's a really excellent album. And yes, you know, it's nice that an artist has the inclination and has the ability to experiment, take risks, and go off and do different things. And he's not just rooted into one area on one track. That's really cool. If you are an artist and you have that ability, yo, go soaring, man. Absolutely. Do something different. Whether or not, you know, the people will like it, that's a different story. Sometimes you just got to do it just for you. You know what I'm saying? Excellent stuff. All right. So, coming up, Sasha Akachita, voiceover, got reactions I got to hit up for you guys. And looking forward to it, man. Always a really, really good mixture of things on this platform. I really dig it for that reason. So, a lot of people don't like that for that reason, you know. Your channel would be quadruple in subscribers if you gave Radiohead the Led Zeppelin treatment, or Tool the Led Zeppelin treatment, or this or this or this. No, man, it's just fine the way it is. Keep the variety and the weirdness and all of that sort of shit coming, because it's really, really cool to be able to kind of expand and go in different places, not just as an artist, but also as a listener, as a fan. You know, you gotta appreciate hearing all kinds of different things. Of course, you know where I draw the line, right? So that's it, man. So I think it's Sasha that's up next, if I'm not mistaken. I'm just going off the top of my head here. I've got the calendar in my mind's eye. I don't actually have it in front of me. But anyways, Cole, thanks very much for this, man. Always a good time checking out Jack White and what he's got to offer. He's an excellent artist, and I'd like to check out all that he's done. Anyways, by the way, yo, so I've got an announcement coming up later on in the day, so keep your eyes and ears open for that, okay? Have a good one, take care, and next time you see me will be tomorrow for either Sasha, is it Sasha, is it Akachita, or is it voiceover? Well, one of those gents, one of their reactions. What else was I going to say? That's what I was going to say also. Earlier, too, I did a reaction to a really, really cool rockumentary, man, called Festival Express. Excuse me. On the Classic Rock platform. So definitely you want to go check that out too. Anyway, I'm going to go and pop some lemon drops. Have a good one. Take care. And I'll see you tomorrow. Peace.